waivers, which means that any team in the league has 48 hours to claim him. If no one claims him, he's out of a job. Like most players at this level, Curtis doesn't have an agent. Instead, he has to track down coaches and make calls on his own.
Well, maybe you should just call Jeff Lund real quick and ask him to stay because...
He won't take my call.
Well, it's 5 o'clock. Why don't you just try real quick?
Curtis's past has come back to haunt him. After the incident with his coach in Tulsa, other teams are reluctant to take a chance on a player many now perceive to be a troublemaker. 2 days after his release, Curtis is still without any job prospects. To complicate matters, he and his family must vacate their Huntsville apartment to make room for a new player coming in. Finally, Curtis gets the break he's been hoping for. With Memphis locked in a tight battle for first place, Coach Doug Shedden is looking to add some more toughness to his team. He wants to sign Curtis as a free agent.
You know, I think he could be give a you know another lift because I think Wolves are always better when they're in packs. So, you know, it's better to have many than just one.
It's Curtis's first game with Memphis, and he wants to make a good impression. He sets the tone early with aggressive play. When a tough guy goes after one of Memphis's goal scorers, Curtis knows what he has to do. But as soon as the fight starts, it's clear something's wrong. Curtis isn't throwing any punches. His left hand gets entangled in his opponent's jersey. When the jersey twists, Curtis's hand snaps. A broken hand for any hockey player is a serious injury. But for a tough guy, it could end his career. After breaking his hand, Curtis is told by his doctors not to play for 4 weeks. But only 3 weeks after the injury, Curtis is back in the lineup. With a brace on his hand, he's not supposed to fight. But the season's almost over, and he's determined to prove to Shedden that he can still play tough.
I won't be able to fight or anything, probably, so it'll be kind of tough to stay out of trouble.
In his first shift, Curtis is true to his word. This elbow he throws almost starts a full-scale brawl.
Get in there!
Leading 5-1 in the third period, Coach Doug Shedden imposes a no-fight rule on his players. But as he's shown before in his career, there's only so far Curtis can be pushed before he retaliates. Shedden is not impressed. He sees Curtis's actions as a breach of discipline, not a sign of toughness. Curtis's career takes a backward step at every turn. It's his first game back in Tulsa since the trade.
Been waiting all year pretty much to go back there. Got a little bit of revenge, I guess, against, I guess not so much the players, but just the coach and the owner, mostly the coach.
But there's more riding on the game than settling a score with his old coach. Curtis still has to prove to his new coach that he has what it takes to play for the Memphis River Kings next season.
Tell him to come in here. Where's Patty?
On the bench,
Ernie?
As game time approaches, Curtis is having problems with his tie down, the strap which prevents a player's jersey from being pulled up over his head in a fight. For Curtis, it's come down to this. He lines up for the opening faceoff against Carlos Soki, the tough guy Tulsa brought in to replace him.
Thank you.
Curtis's tie-down strap doesn't hold. Soki gets Curtis's jersey over his head. A clear defeat.